video, I will help you to find out binomial coefficient using dynamic programming concept. Firstly, just understand basics about binomial coefficient. A binomial coefficient is an algebraic expression that contains terms a plus b. So we multiply binomials as a plus b square, a plus b cube. You know the a plus b square, 1a square, 2ab, 1b square. A plus b cube is 1a cube, 3a square b, 3ab square, 1b cube. Numbers that appears as coefficients. See this, these numbers 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1. Of the terms in a binomial expression, these are binomial expressions, are called binomial coefficients. Okay, so this is basics about it. And binomial coefficient of n and k is written as c n comma k. Either it is written in this way or it can be written as ncr, or simply they will write it nr inside a bracket and a gap in between them. So this is the representation of it. And if you try to find out it using mathematical ways, the simple formula for computing it is ncr is equal to n factorial divided by r factorial into n minus r whole factorial. So just take an example. 5c3 is 5 factorial, 3 factorial, 5 minus 3 whole factorial. Multiplication of with 3 factorial. So I hope you can find out the factorial and it will come out as 10. So this is just simply about what is binomial coefficient. Now I will try to help you to solve dynamic programming concept of binomial coefficient. And please subscribe to my channel if this video is a bit helpful, and share it with your friends, and you can also comment and like my video, and you can give your useful feedback also. So just see the example now. Find binomial coefficient of 5c3 using dynamic programming concept. Okay, I have written it in chart. So to compute this in exams, firstly you have to find out the value of n and r. So here ncr is compared with 5c3, n will become 5, r will become 3. So using dynamic programming concept, you have to use this formula and you have to draw a table like this. So how you have to draw the table, firstly I will tell you. Here you have to write the r values. R will start from, r will end to 3, and it will must start from 0. Remember that you have to start it with 0, you don't have to start it with 1. And similarly with n will end up to 5, and it will also start from 0. So you must have to remember this, that you have to start n and r with 0. R values will be written like this and n values will be written like this. Okay, so first thing you have to remember this. I have made the arrows also. Here we have to write r values, here we have to write n values, and to compute the given table we have to use this formula. Firstly I will tell you a shortcut method to fill this table, then we will use this formula to compute all the values for this table. So just proceed with the shortcut formula. First thing that you need to understand is I value will go from 0 to n. So here n values are there. So I value will go from 0 to 5. And j value will go from 0 to I minus I comma r, minimum of I comma r. So we have to and j where we will find out minimum of I comma r. See this. Here j value, I value is 0, j value is 0. So minimum of these two is 0 only. So we don't have to add j value here. Here I value is 0, j value is 1. So minimum among these is 0 only. So we have to add the j value here. So we will simply put a cross here, because here see, simply you have to see this, j value is greater here. So where j value is greater than I value, then you have to stop in that place only. And again in this case, I value is 1, j value is 0, j value is not greater than I value. Here also j value is not greater than I value, they are equal. Here in this case j value is greater than I value. J is 2 and I is 1. So you have to make a cross here that you don't have to process further. Now again, for this case, here I value is 2 and j value is 3. So you have to make a cross here. And one important thing that you have to see this here, it is making a diagonal. So these crosses are filled diagonally only, but you need to remember also that you have to stop these in these places because of the reason that here j value is greater than I value and j will end to minimum of I comma r. If you are not understanding this, just understand that j value will end only to the place we have to make crosses where this value is I, this value is j, where j value is greater than I value. If it is equal or j value, if j value is equal to I value or j value is less than I value, then it is fine. But if j value is greater than I value, then we have to make a cross and we don't have to process further and in that place also. So this is the first point that you have to remember. And the second point that you have to remember is you have to fill one entire column with all ones. That column will be this column. You have to fill this entire column with all ones. Okay, so just fill the entire column with all ones. Now the next thing that you have to remember, I am telling you a simple trick to solve this. You have to solve it using this formula in exams. You have to give some examples that you have solved this table using formula, but firstly just solve it using the tricks. Now after this, the diagonal that is below this, these crosses, this diagonal, you have to fill that diagonal with all ones again. So what is the diagonal that is below these crosses? This one diagonal I am talking about. So just fill it with all ones. Okay, now you have to compute these all left values. These all left values will be computed by seeing the values that are, see this, this value will be computed using the summation of the value that is its diagonal value and the value that is above it. So the diagonal value, see this, you can write here, draw it, you don't have to draw it, I'm just drawing for your understanding purpose. Diagonal value is 1 and the value that is above this box is 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2, so you have to fill it with 2. Again, for this value, you know the value, the diagonal value as well as the above value. Diagonal value is 1, above value is 2. So 1 plus 2 is 3, so just fill it with 3. Now for this place, diagonal value is 2 and above value is 1. So 2 plus 1 is 3, so just fill it with 3. Now for this place, the above value is 1 and the diagonal value is 1 and the above value is 3. So 1 plus 3 is 4. For this place, the diagonal value is 3 and the above value is 3. So 3 plus 3 is 6. So fill it with 6. I hope you can fill it now. So for this box, diagonal value is 3 and above value is 1. So 3 plus 1 is 4. So just fill it with 4. Okay, this is 4. Now for this place, diagonal value is 1 and above value is 4, so just fill it with 5. We will compute these values using the formula later. Now the diagonal value is 4 and above value is 6. 4 plus 6 is 10, so just fill it with 10. And again here the diagonal value is 6 and the above value is 4. 6 plus 4 is 10, so just again fill it with 10. So in this way you can compute it easily without using formula and using the tricks that I have told you. Now we will compute it using formula and we will verify whether we are correct or not. And in exams, just give 2 or 3 solutions of these boxes using this formula. Examiner will become clear that you have done it using, you know how to solve this and you have done it using the formula. So just do the first case. Let's suppose we are trying to find out the value of c of 1 comma 1. So let's give one example, c of 1 comma 1. So here I is 1 and j is 1. So here I is 1 and this is for I, this is for j. I is 1 and j is 1. C of 1, 1 is 1 only. So we will try to compute it now. C of I minus 1. I minus 1, this is I and this is j. I minus 1. 1 minus 1 is 0 and j is 1. Plus C of I minus 1. 1 minus 1 is 0 and j minus 1. J is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. So just see these two values. C of 0 comma 1. I is 0. J is 1. C of 0 comma 1. C of 0 comma 1 is nothing. So we will not write any value here. And C of 0 comma 0. C of 0 comma 0. I is 0. J 0 is 1. So here we will left it with 0. Here we will write 1. So it will come out as 1 only. So is it correct? C of 1 comma 1 is 1. C of 1 comma 1 is computed as 1 itself. So we are correct. Now again we will take one more example, which is C of 2 comma 1. Suppose we are taking 2 comma 1. Okay. So I value and j value. Here I value is 2, j value is 1. So just use the formula. I minus 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. And j is 1. And 2 minus 1 is 1. And 1 minus 1 is 0. C of 1 comma 1. C of 1 comma 1 is 1. Plus C of 1 comma 0. C of 1 comma 0 is 1. So it is coming out as 2. C of 2 comma 1. C of 2 and 1. C of 2 comma 1 is 2. And here also it is coming as 2. So in this way you have to process. And just to give 2 or 3 examples so that examiner will become clear that you have solved it using this formula. So in this way you have to process it.